In cycle 5, we will try to issue this next instruction, which is a divide. This divide is going to look for this type of a unit and find it. So we're going to mark that ML2 is now full. We're going to say that this has issued in cycle 5. We're going to look at F0 and F6 as our inputs. F0 comes from LML1. F6 is actually in the register file because this doesn't say. So, for example, if this load has been a little bit later, we would have to wait for it. But because it's done, we can read 7.1 and put it here. And then we're going to rename F10 to point to this ML2, which is where we put the divide. And that concludes the issue for this cycle. Now, as far as the dispatch is concerned, we have already dispatched this load, and there is nothing else that is ready to dispatch, so we don't dispatch anything this cycle. In this cycle, this load is still executing. It's going to broadcast its result in the very next cycle, in cycle 6, and there is no result that gets broadcast in this cycle either. So we are basically done with cycle 5. Now let's look at cycle 6. In cycle 6, we're going to try to dispatch this add. There is a unit available, so we will succeed in dispatching it. F8 and F2 are going to be AD1 and LD2. Rename F6 to point to the AD2 now, which is where we put this instruction. And that concludes the issuing of this instruction. Now let's look at whether we can dispatch something. Well, in cycle 5, this instruction is still executing. So in cycle 6, it's going to write the result. But until that writes the result, nothing is ready really to execute. So basically, we don't really dispatch anything, but there will be a write result by the load. As a result of this, several things will happen. First of all, we will deposit the result of the load, which is whatever is at address 245, to the register F2. So let's say that our F2 just became, I don't know, minus 2.5. We can then provide this value also to all of the things that are waiting for LD2. In this case, there are several instructions. So the operand here matches LD2. So minus 2.5 will be captured here. And we are no longer waiting for it. The second operand of this instruction also matches. So we're going to capture it here and mark this as no longer waiting for it. And then the first operand of this matches it, minus 2.5. So we're going to unmark it here too. And finally, because this entry matches LD2, we're going to change the RAT to once more point to the register file. So this concludes the writing of the result. Remember that because now these instructions are actually ready to go, but because that happens kind of towards the end of the cycle, we consider that they cannot really dispatch in the same cycle. Because we are considering that we cannot first broadcast the result and then dispatch instructions that use that result, it's easier if we then first try to dispatch instructions and then broadcast the result. Because if we now considered what can dispatch, this looks like it can dispatch. So we need to remember that the broadcast has happened in the same cycle and this really is not eligible for dispatch yet. So that's why we did kind of dispatch before broadcast. Similarly, it could help if we just did the, you know, dispatch and then issue and then broadcast, just so that, you know, kind of we don't consider things that have just issued for dispatch. But that's easy because only one thing gets to dispatch and it's very, very quick. So, in cycle 6, we have issued an instruction, we have broadcast the result, and nothing really has been dispatched. So now it's time to consider what happens in cycle 7.